So let's take a look at using the Collaborate feature to work with somebody else on the same Pages document at the same time. So here I've created a new Pages document and the Collaborate button is really big and hard to miss up here. Now for this to work, this document has to be saved to iCloud Drive. So you don't have to be using the Document or Desktops feature of iCloud Drive or anything like that, but you do have to have it saved in iCloud Drive. I can see here if I click, it is saved in the Pages folder in iCloud Drive. So that'll work. So now I can hit Collaborate and now I have to notify the other person at the same time as I add them. So basically it's one step. You add somebody and that will notify them that they've been added. So I can do that by mail, messages, I can just get a link and then send it to them some other way. I can use AirDrop. I can use a variety of other things depending on what you have installed. So let's just do mail right now. I'm going to look at share options and I can set it to only people that I invite so they have to log in to be able to see that document, work with that document, and that they can make changes or only view if I want. So that looking good, I will hit share. So now I get an email form and I want to make sure I send this to an email address that's an Apple ID, not to some other email address that the person may be using. And then I just hit send. So now you can see on my other computer here, I'm going to get an email there and that will then contain a link in it which will allow me to share the document. So there's the email and if I just click on this link here, it will automatically request open pages and then when it does, it will open up the documents. Now I've got the document on both screens. And you can see I get a little message that the other person has joined. Now look what happens. If I'm here on the original machine and I go and I type something new, you're going to see it appear there on the other one. And likewise, you could see it appear there if the other person types. So you're actually working on the same document at the same time. But you don't have to be. This could be a way to collaborate in real time with somebody. But you can also close the document. Now I'm not working on it at all. And you can see it gives you a little message here on the second Mac that that person has left. But I can continue working on it. And this person could even leave. So it could even close this document here. And now on my first machine here, I can open up the recent documents there and I'll see the updates there from that person. So this could be something where you could send it off to somebody to collaborate. You can leave. They could come in, do some edits, add something to it. They could leave and you can come back and you can continue to work back and forth like that. So you can work in real time or you can hand the document back and forth as each person needs it. Now to end access, I can hit the Collaborate button again. You can see the people collaborating there. You can hit the three dots here and you can choose to make something view only. You can remove access. So you have those options. Also on this end of things, if you're in the document here, you can go to Collaborate and do the same. And you can see you don't have the ability to remove the original person from it. But you can remove yourself. You can also grab a copy of the link if you need it for something like going to another machine or something like that or saving for future reference. If I were to remove one of these, let's say let's remove right now while this is live, it'll prompt me for confirmation and you can see here this document's no longer available. So a few other things. If you collaborate and you say just anybody with a link and maybe view only, then you can share with anybody. They don't even need to have pages. They can actually be even on a Windows machine because they can then see it in the web version of Pages. So you have that ability and also you can do this in Numbers, there's a Collaborate button there as well, and in Keynote, and it works pretty much the same in all three apps.